What? Okay, then move. I'll get it, honey. I got it, honey. Go ahead, moving back. Okay. Well, we got one. Okay. Yes, we did, honey. You want to pull it up?
Yeah, I'm going to pull it up.
Okay, let me trade you spots. We're on a boat.
I said, there's a snapping turtle on it. And I was right.
Okay, bye. Hop up, bye. Go ahead. All right, you stand right here. No, stand on top of here. Don't go down in, okay? Pull it up. Ready? I'll help you. Ready?
Whoa!
Here we go.
Look how big
he is. Woo! You got one, girl. All right, ladies and squirrels, we're back with the girls. We threw out some jugs yesterday. Didn't show that whole thing because it gets kind of boring. But here they are. Here's the girls.
Hi.
What were we doing today, girls?
Catching snapping turtles.
And did we get skunked?
Yes.
No.
No,
we getting skunked means you didn't get anything. We did. What did we get? Snapping turtle. All right, so we threw out a bunch of jugs, only got one. I think because we at least got that one, we are going to do, Emmy, not near the business end. I think we're going to do a catch and cook. So stay tuned. We're going to come back with a catch and cook. We'll go through the cleaning process and maybe share some recipes or cooking. I'm going to make a couple different things. All right.
Turtle
soup and stuff. All right.
You can honestly use whatever you want on the surface to clean it. It has already been dispatched. There's multiple videos you can watch online to see how you do that. So first thing I'll say is make sure you have a few sharp knives handy and definitely a knife sharpener. I'm kind of showing you the edge of the bottom of the shell, the carapace, where you're going to kind of slip your knife along to take the skin off. You'll see that it's still moving. And you definitely have to remove the claws. Got to do that at first. So, I'm definitely trying to explain something in the video that probably is pointless, which is why I'm doing this. Alright, adjusting it a little bit. It's kind of moving around. Okay, so, what we're going to do is remove the claws. As you can see, it's trying to attack me while I'm doing that, which I don't blame it. It's kind of like skinning a zombie. So you keep going. Just work your way around. I have a bucket sitting off to the side. I'm throwing stuff in so that our dog there doesn't try getting it. Because of course they would, they're dogs. Its tail's still trying to whack me too, and its legs are still moving. Some people leave the whole tail on. I kind of cut halfway down through where I think I'm going to be able to get usable meat from it. So there's that. Now I'm going to start skinning. Like I said and already showed you from earlier around the edges. Just going to kind of move it around. This part is actually super easy in all honesty. I thought it would be kind of difficult. But it's very easy. Just kind of slowly work your way around. You're just loosening it, and then you're starting to skin it back. I don't know if anybody's ever skinned a deer or anything like that before, but very similar. Slowly skinning it back. The skin is super thick. You don't realize how thick it is, how tough, until you start doing it and realize you have to sharpen your knife multiple times through it. Or if you're like do what I do and you just take a couple of knives. So, it's working my way around the front. You kind of get like a big flap from the front, and same from the back. Definitely still going. You can start to see now how the meat of the legs differs from the neck. At least I'm seeing that. And then whenever I spin it around, you'll see that the meat from the neck is actually white. Then from the legs and the tail is dark red. I know my cleaning table is pretty awesome. Real custom. Just kidding. So you can kind of see in there the meat from the neck being white. Go going around the back, and I actually found the front super, super easy to do. And then the back was definitely more difficult and time consuming for me. And if you see any of like the amber, orangish, yellow, that's the fat. You definitely want to remove all that before cooking, because if not, at least I've heard, and I didn't care to try, that it like taints the taste of everything. So I definitely want to leave the turtle fat on there. Sorry for the little pool of blood growing as things go on here. Still going. The nice thing about the having taken the like the claws and stuff, like the I guess the whole paw you could say off first, is as you're skinning up the legs, it gives you something to like edge your finger into and like a hole to kind of pull, keep pulling at the skin. So that usually works out pretty good. Trying to get around the tail now. And as long as you have like sharp knives, that's fine. Believe me, the knives I'm using are not expensive. Got some sweet Sam's Club knives. So, there you go. Trimming a little fat as you go, you know. So now, the fun part, taking that off. There's actually like a little, I don't know, like a little channel that you find. It's very simple to find, actually, and you can slip a knife right down through it pretty easily. I was super surprised the first time I did it. Then you're skinning that away, threw it into the bucket. There we go. So that's kind of what it looks like. Since I've done that, like the legs really aren't moving much now. It's all kind of just there. It's good. Getting the hose, you know, you want to keep rinsing stuff as you do it. Why not, right? Keep it clean. So now I'm going to start to actually take the legs out. I'm gonna work on the front first. Like I said, the front I've found to be the easiest. You're still skinning right along the edge of everything. You can see the difference in the color of the meat there. So I'm gonna start trimming a little bit of the fat as I go. You can see it's a like kind of very gooey, mucousy looking, some of the material that you're removing off of the tissue. Definitely want to take all that off. So there you go, little Lego turtle. Oh, it's a girl, see, I've got some eggs back there. There's Violet checking out in the background. She's like, what the heck, Dad? So you can see how like right inside the shell, the organs are just, they just kind of sit right in there. I mean, obviously, where else are they gonna be? So I'm removing the neck now, definitely some odd tissue there, you know, removing some meat. That's kind of cool. So I'm removing that part, twist it out, like there's a bone in there. If you kind of cut around all the edges of the tendon and everything and twist, it kind of snaps it right out of there. So remove the fat from the other front leg. I'm just realizing this now, looking back at it as I talk to you, that you can still see some movement inside the chest cavity. So here, let's get the back legs out. I'm gonna take it over to the bucket and I'm gonna empty all the entrails out of it here. The dog's sitting there like, come on, give me something so I can probably hide it somewhere that I shouldn't. So even though this is sped up, I'm still obviously taking forever. If you can't tell, I'm still new to this. And look at that. So, probably grabbing something. There we go. Look at that. Some pliers. Oh, you'll see why we need those here in a few. So, cutting around everything to remove the back legs. I did find these a little bit more difficult to remove. Like, I actually made that look pretty easy, actually. Maybe the skinning process of the whole backside was harder than the front, but obviously, I'm, kind of chunking those out pretty quick, trimming some fat off of it. Got the tail and everything there. Gonna take my time cleaning that. So I don't, whenever I was cleaning and stuff like that, and even when I made the soup, I did not take the time to debone everything. I left everything bone on. If anybody out there decides to, try this themselves, you can do it however you want. You can debone, you can keep bone, however. So in this one, I'm twisting the whole back section off, cleaning it, making sure there no, again, no fat and all of that jazz. So, looks like sometimes when I'm looking at this, it looks like I just like to flip stuff around a bunch. So you can see this little area in here. We're gonna get working on that here in a minute. I'm still cleaning the shell off a little bit. So I'm kind of pointing to what looks like little ribs almost, and that's where the pliers are gonna come in. We're gonna snip all those. We're gonna pull the bone out. And then we're gonna take what would be, I guess, turtle back straps. So take the time to pop that out. Just kind of to edge your knife along like the sides of the meat to loosen everything up, and then you'll be able to kind of pinch it and start, pulling it out and trim it off here. That works out. So I'm getting that. And then I'll actually take the shell and I'm going to go set it up for my chickens to kind of peck the meat out of it. That helps me with the cleaning process because then they peck everything pretty much clean and I can hose it down real good and I like borax the inside of it and then clean the outside and put some clear coat on it to save it. So I got my chunks of meat sitting there and now I'm going to show you. So there's the deer back straps, some legs, pelvis area and tail, more legs. All right, so trim and fat. Make sure you just trim fat. Obviously, I keep doing that. And shortly here, we're going to get to the cooking. I'm cleaning everything off again. Obviously, once you get in the house, you're going to want to clean it off too before you package anything. If you're going to freeze it, make sure you wash everything off good. Oh, that leg's still moving. Check that out. You don't notice some things until you sit back and watch it. Oh, still moving. All right. Looks like we're finishing up. And we're in the kitchen. So, got my turtle. I did have it frozen. So, I got my turtle, put it in the pot, put a little bit of water in there. I'm going to be making turtle chili. So I'm going to use some onion powder, garlic powder, salt, and why not some Old Bay. So we're going to use some of that. Shake some spices in there. We're going to let it cook. We're going to keep it on like medium heat for a couple hours. And that's going to soften everything up. I'm going to be making, I don't know if I mentioned it, but turtle chili out of this. Take it to work and feed it some people who have never eaten turtle before. Fun stuff like that. The Old Bay thing, I just read online from different people and then heard from other people that it added some flair to the turtle. So why not, right? Good old thumbs up to starting to cook. So here we are. So I got my nice glove on. Sorry that it's dark inside the pot, but you can see like there's a bone. Obviously, the meat's already kind of coming off everything, and you can shred it by hand. For making like the turtle chili and everything, I'm gonna take it all out. I'm gonna take the bones out. I'm gonna separate the meat. There's still like little pieces of, like whatever connective tissue that didn't break down in there. So I'm gonna try to remove all that as well. But I'm gonna pick it all out, separate it before it goes back in. So there it is. It's all separated. I'm gonna get my knife out, do a nice one-handed, chop. Obviously, it's gonna be super thorough. Man, that's terrible. For the sake of filming, I'm holding that camera, okay? Give me a little credit. So there you go. Oh, look at that magic. It's chopped up. So I'm gonna chop it up. So what do I got laid out? We got some homemade tomato juice. We got some frozen corn. We got some other things like beans and things. And tomato-y things to make the chili.